Today I am going to explain few multiple choice questions for CBSE term 1 exam in 2021. Let us see. If the electron in hydrogen atom makes 6.25 into the power of 15 revolutions in 1 second, the current is, okay, first try to understand the question. One electron is moving in hydrogen atom, it is taking 6.25 into the power of 15 revolutions in 1 second. Number of revolutions per second is called as the frequency, right? First write the given values. The frequency they give in the question is 6.25 into 10 to the power of 15 hertz. This is the frequency. Then question is that how much current flows in the orbit? Why current flows? Because electron in hydrogen atom moves in particular orbit. Due to the motion of the electron, some current will be there. The current basic formula we know, charge by time. What is charge? How much charge flowing? That is charge equal to charge of electron. And time is what? Right? Time means minimum you should take to flow the current. The current will flow only in closed path. Right? If the electron starts at this location, okay, follow the cursor, and it will complete one revolution, again come to the same point, means it will become closed path. In closed path only current will flows. Then for the closed path, minimum it should complete one revolution. The for one revolution the time taken is time period. Period is I equal to E by T, right? But E into this 1 by T we can write. 1 by T is the reciprocal of time period. We can write it as the frequency, right? We know very well that frequency is the reciprocal of time period that you learned in the 11th class. Now, E value 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 and frequency value 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18. Okay. Now, we have to multiply 1.6 into 6.25. If you multiply them, you will get 10 into 10 to the power of minus 19. This new value is 10 to the power of 15. Minus 19 plus 15, you will get as 10 to the power of minus 4. This you will get as 10 to the power of minus 3 amperes. Right? This we can rearrange like this because all the answers are in milli amperes. Right? We can write like this 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3 amperes. Right? 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere is the milli ampere. Right? Because 1 milliampere is equal to, we know as 10 to the power of minus 3 amperes. This is the solution for the first problem. Okay, right. Let us go for the next problem and let us see. Okay, this is our next problem. What they are asking in this? Let us see clearly. A current 16 amperes is made to pass through a conductor. Okay, how much current is passing? 16 amperes current is passing through a conductor. To solve a problem, write the given values first. 16 ampere current passing through a conductor in which the number density of free electrons, number density means what? Number of electrons per unit volume, they give us 4 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube. Right? This many electrons are there per meter cube. And the area of cross section of the wire they give us 10 to the power of minus 5 meter square. Question is that average drift velocity of electron we should find out. Very simple it is. Right? What they gave in this, current 16 ampere is made to pass through a conductor in which the number density of free electrons is 4 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube and its area of cross section 10 to the power of minus 5 meter square. The average drift velocity of free electron is what? What is the formula for the average drift velocity? You know very well, you should remember it, right? I by small n into capital AE. What is I here? 16 ampere. Right? What is n number density? 4 into 10 to the power of 28. What is cross sectional area? 10 to the power of minus 5. Okay, what is the value of E electron charge? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Now let us simplify it. Then for the purpose, what we have to do it here, right? This is a 16 and this one also will cancel. Here you will get a 10 to the power of minus 1 because 16 into the power of minus 1 we write. Now if you simplify here, 1 by 4 into what you will get in the denominator, this is 28 minus or minus 5 minus 1 minus 19 minus 25. 28 minus 25 means this minus all you can add, minus 5 plus minus 1 minus 6 minus 6 minus 19 minus 25. 28 minus 25 means you will get as 10 to the power of 3, right? 1 by 4 into 10 to the power of 3 we are getting, that is 1 by 4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 you will get. This we can write as 1 by 4 value is, you know, 0.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter per second. This we can also write as 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter per second. This is the simple solution for the second problem. Okay, let us see the next problem. The next problem is this is our next problem, right? Listen very carefully. Third problem that I am going to explain now. What is this? Resistance of 10 ohm are connected as shown in the figure. We have to find out the effective resistance. Effective resistance we have to find out in this figure. For the purpose, what we have to do it here? Let us see. If you see this diagram, if you see the diagram in the question, right, all are equal resistances, that is each have the resistance, you know, that is 10 ohm. We have to find out the effective resistance between the A and G, and for that this is A and this is B, and next this is C and this is D. This is the diagram they provided in the question only. Same diagram I am going to draw it here. All are identical. This many resistors are connected as shown in the figure. But we have to do it here. We have to find out the total resistance. Then first of all, we can find out the part to part. Between CD, we should find out the effective resistance. Between CD, these two RR are in parallel. Their effective resistance. Effective resistance between CD we can find out. Okay, what is the effective resistance between the CD? All are having the same resistance, na? 10 ohm and 10 ohm, right? Effective resistance between the CD, we will get like this. Effective resistance between the CD. What they are? There are two resistors are in connected in parallel, each having the resistance 10 ohm. Then we have parallel combination. Direct we can write as R by N formula we can use, or otherwise you use the formula R1 R2 by R1 plus R2, right? And 10 into 10 by 10 plus 10 we will get. That is 10 into 10 by 20 we will get, and 10 to ja, finally we are getting as 5 ohm resistance. Okay, resistance across CD is 5 ohm. Now if you rearrange it, then this is the 10 ohm and the next 10 ohm, right? And the next you will get as 5 ohm between C and D. This is C and this is D, right? And this is B. And here, this is again 10 ohm. This is A and this is G. Look here, just between these two, 10 ohm and 10 ohm, their effective resistance I find out. All are 10 ohm resistances. Now let us see. Now if you see this diagram, between B and D, these two are in series, right? Now their total resistance is 15 ohm. This 15 ohm is in parallel with the 10 ohm. At that moment, if you find out the resistance across BD, right? Resistance across BD, this total resistance, these 10 and 5 are the 15 that are in series. In series combination, we can add them, okay? 10 and 5 are in series and total you will get as 15. That 15 is in parallel with the 10. That's why left resistance you will get as R1, R2. This we have to use between A, B and D. That is 15 into 10 by 15 plus 10 we will get. Right, now let us simplify. Simplification we can do. That is 15 into 10 by 25 we will get. That is 5 3 ja 5 5 ja we will get, and 5 2 ja, and finally we are getting is 6 ohm. Right, now this is A, 10 ohm at A, and between B and D we are getting is, this is B, between B and D we are getting is only, how much we are getting between B and D? Between B and D we got is 6 ohm, right? Now this is G. You see, now how I find out the effective resistance between the B and D? First 10 and 5, these two are in series, total resistance R1 plus R2 we will get here. Okay, that is effective resistance at here. We are getting as 10 plus 5, 15. That 15 is in parallel with the 10. That's why R1, R2 by R1 plus R2 is the effective resistance in parallel combination. Right? And 6 ohm I got. Now you see, between A and B, 10 ohm is there. Between B and D, 6 ohm is there. I want the effective resistance, total resistance that are in series. Then finally, effective resistance we are getting as in the figure. The final effective resistance is very simple, that is resistance across AB plus resistance across BD, right? Because they are in series. Then 10 plus 6 we write, and finally we are getting the effective resistance as 16 ohm. This is the answer, and the first option is the right option, right? Okay. Now let us go for the next question, that is also based on the series and parallel combination of resistors. Okay, let us see. This is our next question. We can easily simplify this. Okay, then how we can simplify it? Then for the purpose, here also the question is that they are asking to find out the effective resistance between A and B, right? Then how to find out the effective resistance between A and B? For the purpose, what we have to do here, we have to use successive simplification, okay? And we should start from this location. We should start from this location. Okay, this you take as A and B. Will you find out the effective resistance between A and B? No, we should not take the A and B because already here AB are there. We take it as a CD, right? This point is C and this point is D. Between CD, will you find out the effective resistance? We take the CD branch separately. They are asking to find out the effective resistance between A and B. There are number of resistors are there. Total resistance we should find out. Between C and D, separate part we can take. This is C and this is 2 ohm. Separate part you can find out it here, effective resistance. This is a C and this is a D, right? Here this is 2 ohm and this is 2 ohm, and the next this is also 2 ohm. Look at here very carefully. There are 3 resistors are there between C and D, whether they are in series or parallel. This is very important. Okay, for example, like this it is there. This is R and this is R. If they are asked to find out the effective resistance between A and B, if you see that they are appearing like parallel to each other, but really they cannot parallel, because in parallel what happens, current divides. In series current will be constant. Okay, for example, I current we are sending it here, that will be go in one direction like this, like this current will to goes. Current does not divides in series combination. Current will same in series combination. This is series combination. Parallel, when we will say, if the same condition is like this there, right, this is R. Now we can say these two are in parallel. How? Because in parallel, if I current enters this side I1, it will goes, right, and this side I2, it will goes. Current will divides in parallel combination. In series combination, current will be same. This you should remember. Based on that, whether they are in series or parallel, we have to decide. Okay, simply by seeing, we cannot decide, okay, whether the branch in that current divides or not divides, we will see. Between C and D, right, and all are in series, because if we supply the current, then the current never divides. And it is, they are in series combination. Then if you find out the effect resistance between C and D, right, we will get effect resistance between the C and D like this. That is, just we have to add the three resistors, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3, because in series combination, just we have to add 2 plus 2 plus 2, so we will get a 6 ohm, right. Between C and D, we got effect resistance as 6 ohm, that we have to add it here, okay. Between C and D, we have to add. If you add it, then what you will get? The next diagram we have to draw it here, that is, this is a 2 ohm and the next one is the 3 ohm. This is also 2 ohm, A, B. Next, what we have to do it here, this is also 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 2 ohm. Next, between C and D, this is C and this is D. Between C and D, we find out the total resistance. The total resistance we got is, between C and D, the total resistance we got is, right, RCD. The total resistance between C and D, right. What you got between the C and D total resistance? Total resistance between the C and D we got is 6 ohm, that we have to add it here, right. And now, if you find out that this, we can take some other two points. This is E point and this is F point. Okay, successive simplification we have to do. We can find out the effect resistance between the E and F. Then for the purpose, you take separately that branch. If you take separately these two like this, for example, this is 3 ohm and this is 6 ohm, right? Then if you see this one, and 3 and 6, if you will give the current, that will divide this side I1 and this side I2. It means 3 and 6 are in parallel, right? Then effect resistance between the E and C, E and F, what you will get? Effect resistance between the E and F, they are in parallel. That's why we have to write the formula R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Now, R1 is 3, R2 is 6, 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6, that is 18 by 9. We will get as 2 ohm. Clear, students? Right. Next, between E and F, we got the effect resistance, that we have to add it here. Now, the next diagram, we have to draw the equivalent diagram for this. That is, between A and B, we should find out the effective resistance. Right. This is 2 ohm. Next, this is 2 ohm. As this diagram, we have to draw. Successive simplification, we have to do. This is 3 ohm. This is 2 ohm. Between E and F, we should write the effect resistance. That is, this is 2 ohm. Okay, this is E point and this is F point. Between E and F, total resistance we got is, how much you got? 2 ohm again. Now, the next points, two points we have to take is, right, and G and H we can take. Between G and H, we can find out the effect resistance. This branch between G and H, you should take separately. If you take G and H separately, right, this is 2 ohm from the G. Okay, next 2 ohm, next 2 ohm. You will get like this between G and H. If you will get like this, then what you will get? These three are in series, then effort ratio between the G and H, this one, right? You see between G and H what you will there, what is there, right? And that is all are in series, we have to add, that is 2 plus 2 plus 2, you will get a 6 ohm, right? And next we have to draw the one more diagram, equivalent diagram at here, that is between G and H we have to add the total resistance. Okay, like this we can go for the successive simplification. In exam no need to do these all things, just for the understanding I am explaining these all things. Directly also you will get, that is between A and B, this is 3 ohm. Right, this is G. This is G. Between G and H, we got total resistance as 6 ohm. Right. Next, we have to find out the effect resistance between the IJ. We will take some more 2 points. This is IJ. Right, what you will get effect resistance between the I and J. Between 3 and 6 are in parallel, that's why effect resistance between the I and J we will get like this. R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 we have to use, that is 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6, that you will get as 2 ohm. That we have to add between I and J, total resistance we got. Right, next step we have to draw like this, that is between A and B, this is 2 ohm, this is I. Between I and G, the total resistance we got is again 2 ohm. This is I J, this had again 2 ohm resistance is there. What is our question? We should find out the effect resistance between the A and B. Right? How you will get the effect resistance between the A and B? If you observe this diagram, right? These 2 ohm, 2 ohm, 2 ohm, all are in series. We have to add just, right? If you add them, then what you will get? 2 plus 2 plus 2. Right? What you are getting? 6 ohm we are getting. This is the total resistance. Okay? If you go for the diagram, like this we have to simplify successful, successive simplification we can tell. How we are solving this problem? You see simply, this first between C and D, this from the right side corner we have to start the simplification. And 2, 2, 2, these 3 are in, right? These 3 are in series first. These 3 are in series. Their effect resistance we have to find out. After finding their effect resistance, right? We are getting the 6 ohm. That 6 and 3 are in parallel. Okay, their effect resistance we are getting 2, that these 2, 2, 2 are again series, their effect resistance is 6, that 6 is again in parallel with the 3, then we are getting the effect resistance 2, this 2 and 2, 2 again series, that final resistance is 6 ohm, the answer is 6 ohm. Like this we have to solve the problem. Okay, successive simplification, we have to step by step, we have to simplify, and finally we got a small part, then by that we have to find out the total resistance. Clear, students? Okay, we discussed the till now 4 problems, and let us continue now. I am going to explain the 5th problem. Okay, this is our next problem. Very simple problem it is. There are 3 resistors. Okay, each of resistance 3 ohm are connected as shown in the figure. Then what is the effect resistance between the A and F? Right, between the A and F we should find out the effect resistance. All are identical resistors. Each of resistance how much? There are 3 resistors are there. Okay, one is 3 ohm, 3 ohm and 3 ohm. Then that are appears like in series. Okay, look at here, this is 3 ohm and this is 3 ohm and this is 3 ohm. If they are up like this there, we can say this is a series combination. Simply we can say it is a series combination. but here there are some connection like this there, right? Due to this, this series will changes into parallel, right? Now we can say that this type of connection is the parallel connection. Then in parallel combination, effect resistance we have to find out the between the A and F, total F, total resistance we have to find out. Okay, due to these wires, that connection will changes into parallel, right? Let us see. Effect resistance we have to find out. How we can find out? There are three resistors are there, each of identical, each of resistance 3 ohm. Okay, direct formula also there. If n identical resistors, each of resistance n identical resistors, n identical resistors, n resistors, n identical, each of resistance R, each of resistance R, if they are connected in series, right, if they are connected in series, then what is the total resistance formula? In series, effect resistance formula is just we have to add R plus R plus R plus, but there are n terms are there, that's why you will get nR. In parallel, if identical are there, identical means what? All having the same resistance. In parallel combination, the effect resistance formula is there, that is R by N. Okay, and these are the, this is the formula. Here we have the three resistors, each of resistance 3 ohm are connected in parallel. Okay, in parallel combination we want the effect resistance. Simply we can find out the effect resistance, right, that is R by N, that is 3 by 3 we are getting as 1 ohm, right? This is the answer. The fourth option is the right option. Or otherwise you can also use another formula, that is 1 by R effective resistance, that is 1 by R1 plus, 1 by R2 plus, 1 by R3. Three resistors are in parallel, but all are having the same resistance. That's why 1 by RP effect resistance is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. We will get as 3 by 3. It will be cancelled. We are getting the 1. 1 by RP is equal to 1 means RP is also 1 ohm. Right? This is the another format to solve this problem. Okay, let us go for the next problem, that is the problem number 6. Look at here very carefully. This is the problem based on the Wheatstone bridge. Okay, Wheatstone bridge, sixth problem. What they are asking in this? In this circuit, in the figure, the value of resistance X when the potential difference between B and D is 0. This is B and this is D. When the solution we have to start, potential difference between the B and D is 0. Means current through the current between the B and D is also 0. Right? When the current is 0, then at that moment the bridge is balanced, we said. Right, bridge is balanced, we can say. Wheatstone bridge is balanced. If the Wheatstone bridge is balanced, there is a some condition is there. If this is P and this is Q and this is R and this is S and this is some galvanometer, right? And if this is A, B, C, D, okay. We have one formula. If current through the galvanometer is 0, then we say that the bridge is balanced. If the bridge is balanced, the ratio of resistances P by Q is equal, we write as R by S. Okay, we have to write this one, P by Q equal to R by S, P Q R S. Okay, now that we have to use it here. Left side resistance is 21, right side total resistance is how much? 8 and X are in parallel, and that between B and C we should find out the total resistance, that will become Q. This is P, Q, this is P, and this is Q, and this is R, this is S. Then the bridge is balanced right here because current through galvanometer here it is 0. But when current through the galvanometer is 0, if potential difference between the B and D is 0, then the current through galvanometer is 0, right? If the current through galvanometer is 0, then the bridge is balanced. If the bridge is balanced, we write the condition P by Q equal to R by S. Then according to that, we will write here 21 P by Q. 21, we write like this. P by Q is equal to R by S. This formula we have to use it here. Then P is what, left side resistance 21, and Q is the right side resistance. 8 and X are in parallel and their combination is in series with the 3. 8x effect resistance is 8x by 8 plus x, r1 r2 by r1 plus r2. This is the effect resistance of 8 and x, and that is in series with the 3. In series r1 plus r2 we should add. This is the total resistance across BC, that is equal to r by s. R is 18, by s value is 6. 6 3 ja we can write, 3 7 ja you will get, and finally we are getting guys 7 is equal to 8x by 8 plus x plus 3. And now we have to simplify a little bit. That is 8x by 8 plus x is equal to 7 minus 3. We will get as 4. And next 4 2 ja we will get. Then if you simplify some more, you will get 2 is x is equal to 8 plus x we will get. And if you find out the x at here, 2x, this x is taken to left side, 2x minus x is x, that is equal to x is equal to 8. Here this is the answer, right? And the next one is, let us go for the seventh problem. Okay, what they are asking in the seventh problem? Listen very carefully. Solution. There are 12 cells, right? The number of cells is the 12. Total number of cells is the 12. Each of EMF 2 volt. Okay, they are connected in the series. Out of that, 12 cells are connected in series. Out of that, 3 cells are wrongly connected. In series means what? Negative terminal of the first cell connected to the positive terminal of the next cell, and so on. Such combination is said to be series combination. If 3 cells are reversely connected, then wrongly connected cells is considered as 3. At that moment, they are asking the total EMF is how much? Each cell having the EMF 2 volts, like that 12 cells are connected, out of 12, m cells are wrongly connected. Okay? Out of n identical cells, out of n identical cells, out of n identical cells, if m cells wrongly connected n identical cells, okay, if M cells are wrongly connected, then effective EMF formula, that is effective EMF is equal to, there is a formula, you should remember, N minus 2 into 2M into E, where E is the EMF of each cell, E is the EMF of each cell. Now here we have to use that formula. Total EMF we have to find out. There are 12 cells, each of 2 volts, they are connected in series. Out of that 12 cells, 3 cells wrongly connected. The total EMF is N minus 2M into E. Remember it. That is 12 minus 2 into 3 into 2. You will get as 12 minus 6 into 2, you will get a 6 into 2. Finally, we are getting as 12 volts. Second option is the right option. Let us go for the next problem. Now I am going to explain the eighth problem. What is this? There are two cells. Okay, two cells each of EMF 1.25. Sorry, there are two cells. They are having the different EMFs. Let's go for the solution. The first cell has the EMF 1.25 volt. Second cell has the EMF 0.75 volt, and each of in the internal resistance same. That is the first one have the internal resistance 1 ohm, and the second cell also have the internal resistance 1 ohm. They are connected in the parallel. Then what is the total EMF? Right, in parallel combination effective EMF is what? Okay, we go for the some formula. Right, that is if cells are connected in series. In series, the total EMF we can find out like this. That is, just we have to add the EMFs of individual cells. Okay, this is the series combination. But in parallel combination, there is one formula is there. That is, effective EMF is equal to E1R2 plus E2R1 by R1 plus R2. This is the formula in the parallel combination. Now here in the question they gave, that is a parallel combination, we should use the formula, that is E1R2 plus E1R2 plus E2R1 by R1 plus R2 we have to take. Right, now E1 value is 1.25, R2 is 1, and E2 is 0.75, R1 is again 1, R1 plus R2, 1 plus 1. In numerator we will get as 2, in denominator also we will get 2. Finally, effective EMF we are getting as 1 volt. That means there are 2 cells of EMFs 1.25 and 0.75 are connected in parallel, but their effective resistance we are getting is only 1 volt. Let's go for the next problem. Okay, very important problem, previous CBSE question, right? Let us see this problem. In an experiment to determine the internal resistance of a cell with a potentiometer, the balancing length is 165 centimeters, the resistance of 5 ohm joined in parallel, the balancing length is 150 centimeters, then internal resistance we have to find out. Very simple it is. Without resistance, with only cell, okay, with cell, the balancing length is 165 centimeters. Now the cell is connected in parallel, okay, resistance connected across the cell. If resistance is connected, right, in parallel to the cell, at that moment the balancing length in the potentiometer, they gave us 150 centimeters. The resistance that we are connected parallel to the cell, they gave us 5 ohm. Question is that what is the internal resistance of that cell? Right? There is a formula is there for the internal resistance, that is L1 by L2 minus 1 into capital R, or simply L1 minus L2 by L2 into capital R also we can write. Now we can simplify it, that is 165 minus 150 by 150 into capital R is 5. That is 165 minus 150 will get as 15 by 150 into 5. And 5, 3 ja we write 30, that is 1 by 2, you will get, finally we are getting as 0.5 ohm. Right, this is the solution for the 9th problem. Let's go for the next problem. This is our next problem. This is the problem number 10. There are two cells are placed in series to produce the null deflection at a distance 204 centimeters in potentiometer. Okay, cells are in series, right? When the cells are in series, their EMFs they give as E1 and E2 and their balancing length they give as 204 centimeters. When the cells are in series, their effect resistance you will get as E1 plus E2, right? And the next time what they are doing, when the one cell is reversed, if the second cell is reversed, right, like this, when the second cell is reversed, now the new balancing length they gave is, right, null deflection occurs at 36 centimeters. The new null deflection balancing length is 36 centimeters. Then question is that what is the effect resistance set here? If the cell is reversed, even minus E2 you will get. Then question is, if E1 is 1.4 volts, then what is the value of E2? This is our question. You know that effective EMF E1 by E2 formula, only single cells if you will use, then we know E1 by E2 is equal to E is equal to phi L formula, you know very well, right? Then according to that E proportional to L we write, then here we write as ES by EP is equal to, sorry, not ES, EP, it is also a series combination, and here we write like this, but wrong connection, we write as ES dash, right? And ES by ES dash, that means just simply we can write E1 plus E2 by E1 plus E2 by E1 minus E2 we should write is equal, on the right side we will get as L1 by L2. Now simplify it. If you will simplify, and finally we will get the, you know, E1 value, L1 value, L2 value, right, and E2 value, you know, E1 value, you know, E2 value you should find out. If you substitute all values and if you will simplify, you will get some value, that is E2 is equal to 0.98 volt you will get. Once check yourself whether you are getting or not. Okay, and let us go for the next problem. Okay, what is this problem? In a meter bridge, the resistance is connected in the left gap and unknown resistance S in right gap. The balancing length is 40 centimeters. Then calculate the value of S. Okay, you know meter bridge very well. There are two gaps are there in the meter bridge. In the left gap, known resistance R is connected. In the right gap, some unknown resistance S is connected. And there is galvanometer. The balancing length they gave us some L. Okay. Then what is the relation between them now? You know very well about the meter bits. We have to use the meter bits formula to solve this problem. Okay, look at here. This is the plug key. And now for the purpose we know formula, first we should write the given values. In the left side gap, this is the left gap, gap 1, gap 2. In the left gap of meter bits, they gave as 2 ohm resistance. In the right gap, unknown resistance S, this we should find out. And the balancing length they gave as, the balancing length they gave as the 40 centimeters. Then we have to calculate the S. The total length of this meter bit is 100 centimeters, you know very well. When the left side balancing length is L, right side length will become 100 minus L. Then you know that formula, left side resistance by right side resistance, R by S is equal to, and left side length by right side length, L by 100 minus L. You should remember like this. And finally, we are getting the R formula, S into L by 100 minus L. Right? You know very well this one. Here you substitute all values. R is 2 ohm. S we should find out. L value they gave us how much? 40. 100 minus 40. Then finally, we are getting, let us simplification we have to do it here. 2 is equal to S into 40 by 60 we will get. 0, 0 cancel. 2, 2 ja, 2, 3 ja, and 2, 2 ja cancel. If you simplify this S, we are getting as 3 ohm. Okay. These are the solutions. The answer is 3 ohm. Right. Okay. Remaining we will discuss later. Thank you to all.